Wait for the stream to catch up to make sure everything is working properly. And here we go. I'm seeing something. Nope, it disappeared. Is it back? Is it... Come on, do something, Twitch. What are you doing? Hello, Twitch. I never have trouble starting the Twitch stream. Let's reload the page. There we go. It was just my Twitch not updating the stream. All right. And Dementia Radio now and recording in 3, 2, 1.
Recorded live on DementiaRadio.org, it's the Funny Music Podcast, brought to you by TheFump.com, where you can download new free comedy songs twice a week. Now, here's your hosts, Devo Spice and the great Luke Ski.
Hey, MarsCon!
Hey, MarsCon!
What are we MarsCon this MarsCon, MarsCon?
It's MarsCon, apparently. Welcome to MarsCon, which is good because I wasn't planning on going to MarsCon this year, so this is fun.
Hi.
Hi.
I literally, just before we started, I got an email that is like basically Andy Merrill's management wanted to get like a list of like what officially he is all doing, and I got this like 10 minutes ago, so it's like, so yeah. Wasn't expecting that to happen just immediately right now. We're starting the podcast, but that's the way it goes. So
it's all right.
Anyway, Devo Spice, what is going on this week?
Well, welcome to episode 715 of the Funny Music Podcast for Thursday, February 29th, 2024. The title of this week's episode is Teeny Tiny Store Crush, which I will put in the chat, and your job is to work that into our conversations somehow. And you may have caught that I said today is February 29th, 2024.
Yeah.
It's leap day. This is the first and only FuMPCast that will ever happen on leap day.
Woo!
I checked. Wow. The last time the leap day was on a Thursday was in 1996, which I think was before Luke and I even knew each other. And the next time it will happen will be in the year 2052. I will be 79 years old. And if I'm still doing this podcast when I'm 79 years old, I want someone to shoot me.
We're just gonna, it'll just be us interviewing the AI algorithms that invented all the comedy songs.
Yes. Yep. So we have Trevor Cochrain with us this week. How you doing, Trevor?
Good. Thank you for having me on this very special episode.
Yep.
where the best promo package for MarsCon is to just repeat it as many times as you can in rapid succession.
That's what we,
Devo, does that sound like exactly what I've been doing for the
yes.
past 20 years?
And in fact, just to be a dick, 1 year I took one of Luke's promos and I edited out everything but the word MarsCon, so it was like 40
oh.
It was like 45 seconds of MarsCon, 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 MarsCon. It was a great promo. So, Joe J. Thomas, unfortunately, will not be able to join us this week. We weren't able to set up an interview or anything, but he said to say nice things about him, so be sure we won't do that when the time comes. All right, let's get into this thing.
Let's get caught up with what Devo and Luke have been up to since last week, or else Devo, if Luke failed and didn't show up.
Hey, what? Oh, he's right.
The people in the chat are wondering where the party room is now that MarsCon is happening now instead of next week.
It's the 12th floor.
I don't have
normally
a 12th floor in my house.
Normally it's the 11th floor, but because it's a leap year, it's on the 12th floor.
So, Luke, what you been up to?
Well, last night...
How did you say anything but MarsCon to that question?
MarsCon!
Last night I got food poisoning. Well, actually, here's the reason. why I wasn't able to, the first thing I was going to say is because I actually, all the things that have to do with, like, not me personally, Lukeski, the comedy musician who's going to perform at MarsCon. I'm talking about the rest of the stuff where, like, I'm handling other people's stuff and things to make things happen. Like, all of that is basically done now. So it's like, okay, I can, there's a few things left I got to do, but it's a situation where I basically got to wait until the last day or two to gather some information and some MP3 files, and then blah, I'll be done. So I've been desperately trying to write a song, and this ain't one of those chicken type songs where, you know, Kyle encouraged me to, you know, write the thing in like under an hour or so and then, you know, pull it out of my butt, you know, and then somehow end up on the Dr. Demento top 10 for 2 months in a row. So, you know, I'm very happy about that, but conversely, this is one of those things where Luke is deep diving into a specific topic and wanting to be super granular about like mentioning, you know, as many important details and things that I could riff on and make jokes about. So I'm doing the thing where I took a bunch of notes on a thing, and now I'm transcribing those written notes into typed up notes where I basically edit out all of the stuff that isn't as important just to get it down to like the sleek chunks of information I can print up on paper and then use that as the basis for writing my lyrics. Have you noticed that MarsCon starts a day from tomorrow? Yeah. So fortunately, I have the awesome Professor Shy Guy has already laid out the track. It's an original song, but it's an original hip hop song. And, you know, I can basically just record all my vocals to, you know, to a click track and then send them to him and say, okay, here, build the rest of the song around this. I've already heard what he's done so far upon my instructions, and it's friggin' amazing, and I'm super happy with it. So, you know, basically I've been trying all week to, you know, finish these notes and then get them typed up and then get them to that stage where I can write the thing, so I can record the thing, so I can, you know, hand it off to Shy Guy to finish up the rest, and then I can kind of scramble and start figuring out, okay, what do I got to do? I got to pack stuff. I got to blah, 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 blah. So, yeah. Yeah, that's all. I've been, other stuff has been going on in a more, no, I probably shouldn't talk about that on the FuMPCast because it's not my business. It's my girlfriend's business. you know, she's fine and everything, but,
yeah.
Wasn't planning on seeing her in, you know, the past week, and then, you know, things kind of changed, and I ended up seeing her just to, you know, just have a good old time, you know, hanging out with her and stuff. So, yeah, that's vague enough.
Is she coming to MarsCon?
Is she
coming to MarsCon?
Actually, yes, she is.
Cool.
And it's interesting. I kind of want to have like a sit down with Kyle and Lindsay, and because Kalani is all like, well, I'm here to help you and support you. Whatever you need me to do, you know, just tell me to do. I'll just do this. I can do that. I can be around you. And it's like, I kind of want to tell Kyle and Lindsay, okay, Kyle and Lindsay, your job is to have Kalani sit down and watch the shows and enjoy the shows and to leave and to, you know, because the best thing she can do to help me is to not be standing in my way saying, what can I do for you? What can I do for you? It's like, no. This is one of the few things in life I know how to do. Just let me do the thing and bop around and do the things. I just want her to see the shows and like get to know all of the people in our weird bubble of friends and have a good old time. She already knows Colin Lindsay. She's met Ian, you know. So yeah, it's going to be a good old time.
Cool.
Yeah, I'll have to tell you some other stuff later. That's funny. But again, I don't want to say that over the public airwaves. And oh, well, I'll save that for later in the show. Okay, so yeah, what have you been up to?
Well, I had one of those birthdays that seems to be so popular these days amongst the young people.
Woo, birthday!
Yeah, so I'm now older than I was last week. That's how it works. I got the new Mario vs. Donkey Kong game for the Switch. I've been playing the crap out of that. That's fun. And Jen got me this custom, I was going to bring it down and show it, but it's upstairs. This custom Funko Pop. It's a Devo Spice Funko Pop.
Oh, cool.
It's really cool, except they screwed up the beard color, and it's gray instead of red. Oh. So they gave her the option of, like, doing it again, which meant it wouldn't have been, I wish she wouldn't have had it in time for my birthday, or giving her a discount. And she was like, I'll take the discount. He can paint the beard. So I'm going to break out my acrylic paints and I'm going to color the beard just like I do in real life, and it'll be fine.
Yeah, I was thinking of getting one of those for myself too.
And now I'm starting to think, like, I don't know how much they cost, but now I'm thinking, like, potential FuMPfest raffle item next year? Like, maybe one of the guests of honor, or Ian, or whatever.
Get all four members of Cirque du Soleil and mount it into a big piece of tile.
Dude. Yeah, I got to see how much these things cost, because we may not raise as much money as the things cost.
Yeah.
I posted
remember
a new
the time
episode.
We did the,
go ahead.
Remember the time at FuMPfest we had the raffle with the two big items? Like, there were other items, but they were the two big items. And then the two winners of the big items were your dad and my mom.
Yes.
It's like, dog, why do we even do things?
Hey, that was the year my father won the sketch that I did of Bonnie Gordon from one of the FuMP album covers. And he was so happy to have that. So,
wait, was it Bonnie or was it Carrie?
No, it was Bonnie.
Oh, okay.
Because it was her, like, strapped in an electric chair with, like, the sorting hat from Harry Potter on her head. And
oh, okay. I was thinking of the one that was, like, Carrie was sort of a devil, but it was, like, in the psycho shower thing. Or
oh, yeah, that's
like that.
The cover of FuMP 44. That's a painting I did, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
I posted a new episode of The Insider today. That'll be showing up in the podcast feeds for those of you who listen to that thing. My short film, Talk to the Hand, is just about done. I thought it would be done before the podcast tonight, and then I watched it because I need to upload it to Vimeo so I can submit it to a film festival whose submission deadline is tomorrow. So I'm going to do that after the show tonight. But I was watching it, and I caught one little minor glitch in the end credits, and it's the type of thing, I don't even know if, like, most of the audience would even notice it, but it's the type of thing where I'm gonna see it every time I watch it if I don't fix it. So I'm like, I'm gonna just fucking fix it and move on with my life. So it's an easy fix, so I'm gonna do that after the show tonight, get it a, you know, new version rendered, watch it again from beginning to end, because I know if I don't, I'm gonna screw something up. And then upload it and submit it, and it'll be done. And I've started listening to the FuMPfest recordings from last year, which is something I probably should have started doing in November. I need to put together, you know, the next compilation album, the fundraiser compilation. And I was like, well, I, you know, should have done this sooner, so I could have had it done in time for MarsCon, but oh well, that ain't going to happen now. But the funny thing is, we recorded an episode of the FuMPCast live at FuMPfest, and Trevor was the guest on that episode. So I just listened to that episode again because I was re-listening to all the recordings.
I think when that happened, you also had trouble with Twitch too. So I, like, came on and you were having trouble with Twitch again. I was like, God, it's me. It's just me that's causing these issues.
Yes, the good old days. I've started watching Resident Alien. Have you seen that, Luke?
I haven't seen it, but I know what it is, and it's one of those shows that's kind of been on my, I really should start watching that list because I love Alan Tudyk and it's a sci-fi comedy.
Yes.
So, yeah.
And I'm only two episodes into it so far. I'm freaking loving it. Alan Tudyk is as brilliant an actor as he always is in this thing, just because he's an alien in human form, and I don't want to give anything away, but he has to learn how to act human, and he hasn't quite figured out laughter yet. So the laughing that Alan Tudyk does when his character has to laugh is hysterical. So highly recommend this show.
The latest Disney animated feature, Wish. He's the voice of, I forgot the character's name now. There's a talking goat in it. and it basically, it's Alan Tudyk doing the voice of the goat, but he's doing, like, it's like the same voice he does for Clayface on the Harley Quinn series. Like, Oh, yes. Hello, I'm a talking goat. It's, so it's like such a weird voice to be coming out of a little baby child goat. So, you know, whenever that hits Disney Plus or something, you know, if nothing else, watch Wish for Alan Tudyk as a talking goat.
Okay. Yeah, absolutely. Will do. I love him so much. He is so good. And he's in,
he's in a lot of things.
Yeah, no, there's some other show. It's some detective thing. Crap, I have it written on my list. What is it? Dirk Gently's Holistic Detective Agency, which is on the Roku channel, and it has Alan Tudyk and Fiona DeReef in it. And Fiona DeReef is, I don't know if I'm saying her last name right, but she's on Chucky, that horror series on Sci-Fi, and I've been watching that. It's on Shudder, and she's like as good as Alan Tudyk is as far as character actors go. So like the two of them together in this show, I'm like, how am I not watching this show? So it's on my list.
Is Chucky good?
Chucky's great. Yeah.
Oh, as long as we're talking about entertainment things, like an episode or two ago when Ian was on, we were talking about movies. I saw that movie Bottoms, and it is hilarious. It is so good. Mm. It's like, I think about like back to when I was like around, you know, whatever, 12, and like certain movies came out that just like, you know, like this is my movie for the rest of my life. Things like Goonies or whatever the hell else, you know. So it's hilarious, but I love thinking about, because it's the two lead characters are these high school, you know, lesbian girls who are like total outcasts. And I just love thinking about all of the thousands of outcast lesbian high school girls in the country who are going to see this movie, and this is going to be their movie. This is going to be their thing, like for the rest of their life. It's like, I'm so happy for them that they have this. It's so good.
Nice.
I also saw Dumb Money, which was also really good and like educational, like to learn all the stuff you were talking about in the Stonks song.
Yeah. Yeah, I wanted to see Dumb Money because, like, I should have been in it because I was part of that whole thing. Like, I made, $3,500 during that whole situation by, wow, you know, throwing money at these stocks that Wall Street Bets on Reddit just kept pumping up. So, it was great. I think that's the money I used to buy this laptop, actually. But...
It actually got me to the point where I was thinking, like, you know, what if I invest? Because I was talking to Kalani, and she looked up and she saw that like AMC stock is like currently at like $5, you know, a share, and that, you know, a couple of years ago was like $100 a share or something. And I was just thinking, like, if I buy stocks in AMC, could I like potentially make enough money to like, you know, pay off my car or whatever? But I generally don't have money like that to throw around. So
yeah.
Anyway.
Yeah, you kind of got to get lucky with a lot of this stuff. I see.
Anything else happened this past week?
No, that's about it. So, Trevor, what have you been up to?
Oh, I've been beyond busy, and I can't lose any more hair. I've lost all of it, but a lot of fun stuff. I'm working on a couple of non-comedy albums. I actually have a friend who lives in Culver City who's been egging me on to take the plunge and move out there, because he's from the Midwest too, and he moved out there, and he's like, you know what's great about out here is that it's not 70 degrees and then 40 degrees. It's like, if it rains, that's a problem, but it's like, it's just sunny most of the time. And me and my partner are thinking about, like, you know, we're thinking about moving, so that's been on our mind. But mostly just after my band finished our album last year, I was like, I don't want to take on any more projects. It was too much. I can't, I'm out of it. But yeah, no, it's been, you know, life is lifing, as they say. Mm-hmm. And, yeah, but, I did want to say, by the way, it shouldn't be a surprise, Luke, on the fact that song popped off. It's one of those things where I felt like you made it like in such a quick like instance of time where it was just like, oh, this is just like a lightning in a bottle type thing. And then Devo, that song you made about, because I've been trying to catch up on, like, I've missed a bunch of FuMP recordings, but the Doctor Who song you wrote, they're like, this is like the dumbest thing ever. And I listened to it and I was like, this is like almost like a classic Depeche Mode song, sort of. Like, if you slightly tweak the instrumental, I'd be like, because I was like, the music's brilliant, the sounds were like great. I was like, so yeah. But yeah, kudos to both of you for putting out good stuff recently.
Which song was that?
I think I can't remember the title of it. It's been a minute. I'm like,
which I haven't of the done a Doctor Who song. Yeah, I know.
Which of the Doctor Who song? Let me dive in here and figure it out.
I've done at least like, 14 of them.
It's one of the more recent.
Oh, Mavity is Stupid. You must be talking about.
Yes, okay. Mavity is Stupid. That's the title. It was like on the tip of my tongue, and I was like, I can't place it. But I was like,
I forgot, and I didn't even consider that a Doctor Who song in my head because yeah, you're right. It is technically.
Yeah. Yeah. So I'd say take. I was like, the instrumental of this is like, this is good, but like, yeah, no. So I've been mostly just catching up on media that I've put behind. I guess the big major thing that's happened is my partner and I finally convinced her to watch Twin Peaks with me. And so she's been struggling through that. I'm like, don't worry. You're going to be so excited once we start getting into the weird stuff. And we made it to the first scene with the Red Room, and she has been like, I don't know if I want to continue watching this. So, but yeah, it's been good. Life's been pretty all right.
Cool. So. Yeah, I've been watching Resident Alien on the TV in our bedroom, so my wife has caught pieces of it, and I've caught her like paying attention to it because she doesn't like to admit that she likes that kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
So, but she's like, She's been sort of getting into it.
Right. I've wanted to watch. I am so behind. Like I said, I'm so behind on so much stuff. For some odd reason, I'm on a terrible Walking Dead kick, and I hate myself because I'm like, I'm in season 10, and I'm like, there's episodes where it's like, oh, this is actually really good, and then there's episodes where like, I don't know why I'm continuing to watch this at all, but I was like, you know, like it has this weird fluctuation, which is why people stopped watching it, because it's like, I don't know if this is good or bad anymore, but it's at least keeping me on the edge of my seat.
I gave up on Walking Dead, I want to say it was season 7, and then like it kept going, and then I came back to it, and like I got caught up, I picked up where I left off and kept walking, and then it got better as it went on, so like seasons 8 and 9 were better than 7. The one like the 7, I think, was the one they were building the bridge, and it was just like it's like 4 episodes of people building a bridge, and I'm like, what the hell? There's not even any zombies in this episode. What are you doing?
Yeah. I feel like they should have leaned into more of like the Western stuff, because once you get in back into season 10, it's like, oh, like the zombies are like becoming an issue again, and then it goes into this very like timely but very try hard message about like wealth inequality, because there's a settlement of people that are like rich, Gatsby weirdos in the Commonwealth, and then it's like, I don't understand how any of what is going on. So it's
I really liked the series finale that they did, because they suddenly remembered they're supposed to be zombies again, and it was very zombie heavy, so I enjoyed that.
Right. So, but I'm almost there, so not that anyone cares about this being spoiled, but I do now. So
there's zombies. Spoil it for me. It's all you need.
There's
to know.
Zombies in it. Thank God, The Walking Dead had zombies in it again. So as you might expect,
you posted a song.
I did post a song.
You posted a very actually, long song.
I apologize for anyone who started it, who started it. You know, it's one of those things where it was like, we were, it's funny, cause I'm actually as much of an accomplishment as I think that is, I'm actually here to promote my, my multi-level marketing company, Teeny Tiny Store Crush. So, the 8-minute song, that's fine. But that's mostly what I'm here to do. So if anybody wants to get my upline, that'd be great.
Well done. All right, so yeah, so give us a quick intro to the song, and we'll give it a listen.
Yeah, so hopefully we don't lose people in it, because I think we made it, hopefully we made it interesting enough. But yeah, it started almost the exact same way you were describing the song you're working on, Luke, where we literally had a metronome, like a beat, just an 808 drum beat, and we improvised over it. And my friend Gus, he's the main vocalist in the front half, and it was in his garage last February, so about a year ago, and it was so cold. And it helped with the mood of the song, but we basically just improvised the whole thing, switched it into a piano ballad with just some basic chords, and then that was it. And then I didn't know what we were going to do with it, and then we were like, it's like we're not qualified to write songs that are this long, so I stitched the instrumental around just like, what key did we kind of sing close to? Because there was no melody or anything. And then we re-recorded the vocals and threw some samples in there and threw some cool interpolations in there. And yeah, we ended up with this big prog nightmare that ended our last album. But there's some cool samples from Beetle Adventure Racing in there. If you listen closely, the bells.
We
got to
talk about that after the. Yeah, we got to talk about that. So.
Yeah. So anyway, but yeah, so improvised from memory. We tried to remember what Frankenstein was, and then built the instrumental up around it, and then we made this version with the orchestral backing for the FuMP, because we wanted to re-release it as a new song and not just keep putting out stuff that we had out for months. So. Yeah.
So here is the modern Prometheus orchestral FuMP version by the Thumbnuts.
Pick her up by the body. Later that night, Vince and Frankenstein got a telegram. It said,
the whole town now surrounds you. We're all mad at what you did. You made a goddamn monster out of body parts and shot it back to life. You didn't know what the fuck you were doing. You set it on out to life. And then it met a kid down on the river bed. You threw it into the lake. One of us in the mob is her mother and father, and we're mad as hell. Hey, look at you, Vincent Frankenstein and Igor, you old twat. Why the hell were you helping him? Now look at what you brought. Hey, Igor, you hunchback fuck, or you upright little cuck.
That's what the whole telegram said, and that's why Vincent cried.
Why are you crying, Vincent?
That's what Igor asked.
I just read a telegram to us that says we're surrounded and about to be killed, because what we did was questionable and bad, and now we are facing repercussions for what we did. And you and me are in this together. We both know what we did.
Very cool song. I love when we have horror stuff on the FuMP.
Did we lose everyone because of the aggressively unnecessary length of what we made?
We still have 9 viewers on Twitch. We were at 10 at one point, so we lost 10% of our audience, I guess.
Yeah. But,
what are you going to do?
All right.
So you improvised these lyrics?
Yeah, so we just literally picked a tempo, and we just had set up a mic, and I brought basically my whole studio up to his barn to record we recorded more than just this song, but we were like, we need like one more, and it was originally going to be like a 3-minute thing, and then we're like, once we realized we didn't have like an ending song, we're like, nobody's going to listen to it anyway, let's just go nuts. And so we just improvised it. We basically, most of the stuff you hear in the song, it was done in the first take, and then we went back through and like touched up some lines and stuff, but it's pretty much exactly how it came out. And then I was like, it was magic, and we laughed at it ourselves, so we're like, we're not going to touch it, we're just going to preserve it. And then that was, the first half was just to a beat, and then the second half was just to a loop of piano chords. But yeah, that's basically all it was. We didn't have anything else to go on, and then I built the rest of the arrangement around that.
So I'm curious why you decided to take that approach, because it seems like everyone else who would, if they want to write a song about Frankenstein, they'll watch one of the movies or read the book or something. Why do
you
do it from memory?
Well, you know, it was funny. I think it was because like we had, because we Gus and I have like, we have a love for an appreciation for like old horror movies and more obscure horror films. And we were like, that story has been adapted so many times that there's no way we could it was hard finding the joke. We initially tried to write out some jokes for it, and it was just difficult to find it. And I said, maybe let's just improvise some stuff and then see which lines, you know, like stick. And then it just, you know, just kind of poured out. And there's also throughout the song, Vincent Frankenstein's name changes. It's like Henry, and then it's something else, and that's like, we did change that line because it's like it references each of the main adaptations, like the book and then the movie and then the Daniel Radcliffe movie that came out a few years ago.
Oh yeah.
So but yeah, no, it was just literally a just exercise to try and get out an idea, and then we just ran with that.
That's really cool. It's an interesting way to do things. I mean, I've seen people improvise songs before, but I've never seen people like improvise lyrics and then build the music around it. It's an interesting concept. I don't know that I could do
Well, we can't and shouldn't be allowed to. The technology has allowed people to make some terrible decisions because they know they can, including us. But, you know, it was one of those situations where it's like, at a minimum, the backing instrumental is fire. We can't sing, but we'll make the instrumental slick.
So please tell me the first time you mixed the backing instrumental with the vocals and heard it together, you went, "It's alive!" Please tell me you did that.
Yeah. Well, yeah, and then, you know, like there's the little snippet from the movie in there too, because we're like, we wanted it to kind of like, once we realized we're like, you know, like starting to play around with like, cause the opening bass line you hear after the bells and stuff, that's a Metallica song. Like it's just, we just replayed from a Metallica song. So we interpolated it. I could not think of like how to get into it. Like, cause it was like, that was the first thing. And I was just like playing around, like noodling around. I was like, oh crap, that's what that is. And I was like, we'll just roll with it. We'll do the proper interpolation credits for it, and we'll roll with it. And then from there, it turns into like a totally different thing that was based around that key that the bass was in. Because that's also, Gus doesn't sing in a key so much as he kind of like hovers around it, and so like that's kind of where he was hanging out. So I was like, all right, it'll sound harmonically okay if we stay in that area.
So. So what was the Beetle Adventure Racing sample? Because I couldn't pick anything out that I recognized.
Yeah, so if you listen, not that I'm advocating you do this, but if you listen to the original version, which does not have the orchestral backing, you'll hear it. The bells at the beginning, the opening bells, so I was like trying to like just get inspiration for it, and I was like, this has like kind of the goofy energy of, there's a track in that game called Wicked Woods, and it's like the last track you get in
the
game.
It's awesome.
The last one.
It's an awesome track.
And so it is an awesome track, and I've been slowly remaking these for Mario Kart 8 on the Switch. Like, I've been very slowly. I have the 3D model of the of each of the levels, because I love Beetle Adventure Racing. It's one of my favorite games.
Yeah, me
it
too.
It still like holds up really well.
Oh yeah.
Oh, that's good. Yeah.
What game is that again?
Beetle Adventure Racing. It's a a racing game for the Nintendo 64 where you play the Volkswagen Beetles that came out in the 90s, the updated design.
Oh, okay.
And it's
I was thinking it was Beetles Adventure Racing. No. Like John Paul, Ringo.
But it's three exceedingly long laps around whatever the environment is. Like I like each lap will take you 3+ minutes. So like these are 10-minute races, which in a video game is insane. And as you're going through it, there are these hidden boxes that have points, and each level has 100 points hidden. So there's 2-point boxes, 5-point boxes, and 10-point boxes. And you have to find like secret, you know, ways to, you know, the secret paths like through the woods and stuff to find all the boxes. So there's like one true path you can take where you can get all 100 points, and then you still have to win the race. It's just it was such an amazing combination of racing and exploration and incredibly creative like level design. There's a level where you're going through the woods and a T-Rex comes down to bite at you. There's another level where you go through a volcano and there's a dragon inside. And then there's the ghost level where if you veer off the track and go into the woods, you go into this haunted house and like jump through it and break through the stained glass window and stuff. It's such a cool game. I highly recommend it.
Yeah, it's very good. Well, it's not to go on a tangent just about this game, but it's a very good game. It started as a Need for Speed game. It was like going to be the Need for Speed exclusive for the N64 because PlayStation had it and PC had their own. And so they made these incredible tracks. Like back when EA was really good, made these incredible tracks. So like the layouts are beautiful and the cars handle really well. Like everything's like spick and span where it's like, oh, this is like a AAA experience. And then what happened was Volkswagen came to EA and they're like, we're re-releasing the Beetle. Can we license you to make a game for us? And they were basically like, we have a game already made. And so they swapped out all the Porsche and Ferraris with Beetle equivalents. And so like it handles and plays like the best Need for Speed game. And the tracks are like that. So it's like AAA quality. If you have an N64 emulator, you should play it. Cause it's still very, very good.
It holds up. It's a really fun game.
Soundtrack's banging too. The soundtrack is killer.
I was happy when I found the way to go over the ski jump in the mountain level because I like really wanted to do the ski jump, and then I did it the ski jump, and then the crowd cheered when you land. It's great.
Yeah, I do like Beatles Adventure Racing though. Hey, it's George here, or this was the it's Ringo here. Pick your car. It's like this
that could
very,
be fun. Yeah,
very, very slow and themed. But I got the ROM for Beetle Adventure Racing that I've been working off of, and there's a tool that they make for PC where you can replace sounds, so you can mod ROMs. And I took out the songs, and so you can hear this if you listen to it, where there's a couple of motifs where it's like boo doo 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 doo. And that is lifted from that little guitar lick, and then I built the main guitar riff around kind of like a Van Halen type scale. It's all been like buried under the orchestra now, but it's the orchestra is then based around that, okay. So they're kind of doing the same thing. But yeah, so it uses the bells, the owl, the bats, all those little things are in Wicked Woods, and then uses a little Frankenstein sample, and then the main guitar riff, the main music is just something I like wrote after I like figured out what key that's the Wicked Wood song and The God That Failed by Metallica are in the same key. So I wrote the rest of the instrumental around like, okay, incorporating those two. And then the second half is in a different key that I can't remember right now. But second half ended up being like, I played around with it. And then eventually it came to the solo section. I wrote a synth solo. And then I was like, It's like another thing where I was like, oh, this is basically that solo from that Dream Theater song. And so we re-recorded that to like, it's not exactly the same, but it's like thematically, like it follows kind of the same path. And I was like, whatever, we're going to just make an homage. It's a prog song, or it's just an homage to these other influences we have. So
Well, it's very cool. It's a remarkable end product for something that was put together so weird.
Well, yeah, and I appreciate you guys showcasing this, because when you know, we talk about what other song are we gonna, you know, we want to submit one more song from the album. I was like, let's test people's patience and just make something really, let's think something really big. But you know, again, it was one of those things where we laughed when we were making it, and we're like, we hope that, you know, like, you give it a platform, see if anybody else likes it. But yeah, we appreciate you guys popping down the Beatle cast here.
So are the Thumbnuts done? Are you?
I could.
Yeah. So we you know, it's funny that the song about Frankenstein would be the thing that ended up killing the band, but it was really a situation where the friend that's out in Culver City is one of the three band members, and he does like the Frankenstein growls and stuff. And normally he's featured on more songs, but he just is like, it's just like impossible to like coordinate bands mm-hmm. like tightly around that. We haven't figured out exactly how to do that. So, but yeah, we just decided we can't do anything bigger than that's 170 tracks that are in that. And I was like, I want to maybe be like somebody's backing band, because it's like, I can't sing, Gus can't sing, Tommy can kind of sing, we can write music though. And so that's, yeah, we just decided we're kind of, you know, we did it since high school, and it was an appropriate time to be like, this is the biggest song we have, that's the biggest album we're gonna do, we got a lot of streams off of it, a lot of streams relative to
right,
none.
Yeah.
right and so we were happy with it, and so if anybody out there and that's part of the FuMP needs session musicians to play on whatever, not to boast, but we're good, we can clearly play whatever you need. So if you need a cover song or you need an original thing, we're just looking to work on other stuff now. So
makes sense. Sure.
But we want to keep doing comedy music. So
cool. What were you gonna say, Luke?
I was gonna say that could be a new motto for us. The FuMP. Let's test people's patience.
There's a t-shirt. All right. So do you have anything you'd like to plug?
No, that was literally it. If you made it through what we just played, then I appreciate and thank you. But the main thing I want to plug is, if you do need somebody to play on your track, or you need a full backing band, I'm not running a business. We're just doing it for fun. So just hit me up. I'll work on it for free if you give me an appropriate lead time.
How are you with hip hop? Because I got a parody I got to get done.
Good. I've done a few I've done a few non-comedic stuff. I do a lot of production stuff. That song is that was the biggest thing I've ever done. It was clearly too much, and we had to finish it in a month. But we can do whatever genre. I'm
cool.
I'm flexible.
Cool. I will hit you up.
Cool.
In the meantime, look up the song Annie Up by MOP.
Okay. I can do that.
Give you an idea what you're getting yourself into. All right, we're gonna do some news and play Joe's song. Are you sticking around, or are you gonna take off?
No, I'll stick around. I'll stick around.
Okay, let's do some news.
This song is about where we are right now.
The world's longest running comedy music concert series is back.
Having a good MarsCon? Fantastic.
MarsCon 2024 is taking place March 8th through 10th at the Hilton Minneapolis St. Paul Mall of America Hotel in Bloomington, Minnesota.
Oh, I just did the thing where I ad-libbed so long that it got awkward.
Have fun and get wasted. Tell me more.
This year's event will have performances by The Great Luke Ski, TV's Kyle and Lindzilla, Insane Ian, Power Salad, Meow Meme, Nuclear Bubble Wrap, Holy Bong Water, Scooter Picnic, Jake Dewar, and this year's comedy music guest of honor, Cartoon Network legend Andy Merrill, the comedian behind the demented sensation that is Brack.
I like hubcaps, I like laundry, I like waffles, I like ant farms, I like reset, picnic, and Eden Park in Maine.
Registration for a weekend badge is $70. To pre-register and for more info on MarsCon, visit MarsCon.org.
Moisture, moisture, moisture.
That's not creepy at all. I'm going to write my mom tonight. What did you do today, Bonnie? I drank water. Everyone screamed moisture at me. It was great. It's a bit.
But whether you're attending or not, you can still help out by ordering the MarsCon 2024 Comedy Music Track Fundraiser Album, available as an MP3 download for $30. It's just under 4 hours of highlights from all the live concerts of
MarsCon 2023.
So, Bryn,
yes.
Next year when you're editing the fundraiser album, the most important thing you need to remember is to include this clip of me right here telling you to put this in the fundraiser album.
This year's album includes comedy music by MarsCon 2023's music guest of honor, Bonnie Gordon.
Acknowledged.
Sing with me just for today. Maybe tomorrow, Kaylee will take you away.
If you'd like to hear a free 30-minute preview of the collection, there's a link to download that at our website.
I don't know what I'm recommending you do. I have no good advice for you, but they gave me a microphone, so it makes my opinion sound important.
You can order and download the album right now from the shop page at MarsConComedy.com.
That sounds like a brilliant idea.
I forgot my emotional support spatula at home.
Thanks for listening, Funny Music fans, and we hope to see you all at MarsCon 2024.
Thank you, MarsCon.
Time for Funny Music News. Something, something, something.
In the news, Marc Gunn has a new album coming out on March 4th called Come Adventure With Me. As he says, sci-fi-ish music is Celtic-inspired music fused with science fiction and fantasy. Come Adventure With Me continues in that vein. You'll get an album fusing traditional music with a healthy dose of original songs inspired by Firefly, Doctor Who, Hobbits, and Celtic legends. He has a couple of different options available for the purchase, including the digital, the autographed CD, and what he's calling the Ultimate Adventure Bundle, which is an autographed copy of the CD, a booklet with all the lyrics and song credits, two album pins, a compass and a dragon, a poster of the album graphics, and a Dragon Adventure tote bag. There are also other options available, including just the CD or digital download and songbook. This will be available on Mark's website at markgunn.bandcamp.com. That's Mark with a C, not to be confused with the Mark with a C other guy, but this is Mark with a C, markgunn.bandcamp.com, available on March 4th. And also coming out tomorrow, March 1st, is the new album by Via Bella, Live in Germany, which includes the MST3K cover of Rocket Man, and Let's Not Fight About Star Trek, and many more. Available tomorrow on their Bandcamp page, which is viabellaband.bandcamp.com. And the FuMP newsletter went out the other day with features about MarsCon, the featured video, new releases by Via Bella, and more. You can, if you're not on our mailing list, you can view it online at tiny.cc/FuMP0224. tiny.cc/FuMP0224. FuMP checkouts are still disabled. I'm still working on it. I've made great progress. I'm almost done. I just need like another couple of days to just bear down and code to get all the final pieces in place. Like the payments work. Now I need it to so that like when you buy a download, it emails you the link with the download. So that's the part of the process I'm at right now. The Dementia Fun Bus is back. If you need a ride from Chicago to Minneapolis for MarsCon, you can join the Dementia Fun Bus. Contact Ken Sherlock on Facebook Messenger or email him at mdmndk@aol.com. The bus leaves Chicago on the 7th and returns on Monday the 11th. Luke, any other MarsCon updates?
Yes, fundraiser update. As we've said before, the initial goal was achieved. Our first stretch goal of $606.55. We are currently, we've raised $153.32 as of today, which is 25% of the way towards our first stretch goal with 8 days left until MarsCon. So we need to sell about 16 more copies of the of this year's collection or any year's collections to hit that amount, and if anyone's interested in getting a bundle of all, whatever it is, 17 or 18 of the collections at once, if you give us a donation of $200, I'll give you the link to be able to download all of them. So, you know, that is the deal. So, yeah, it would be very nice if we hit that goal in the next 8 days. So there you go. Go to MarsConComedy.com, click on the shop page to get this year's collection, which is, features the concerts of MarsCon 2023. Or if you want to look into the past year's collections, click on the page called Past Fundraisers. So there you go.
All right. Tour dates. On Sundays in Nashville, Tennessee, Steve Goody hosting at the Bluebird. On Sundays online, Two Sleeps. Mondays online, Steve Goody and Brad Tassel at virtualcomedyshow.com. Mondays and Wednesdays online, Bill Larkin. On the 1st in Sauterton, Pennsylvania, Carla Ulbrich. On the 2nd in Roosmore Community, New Jersey, Carla Ulbrich. On the 3rd online, Escape from the Secret Lab featuring the Consortium of Genius. On the 5th in New York City, Carla Ulbrich. On the 6th in Voorheesville, New York, Drew Jacobs. On the 6th in Sunnyvale, California, Phil Johnson and Roadside Attraction. On the 8th online, Carla Ulbrich. And the weekend of the 8th through the 10th in Bloomington, Minnesota, Jake Dewar, The Great Luke Ski, TV's Kyle and Linzilla, Insane Ian, Power Salad, Nuclear Bubble Wrap, Holy Bong Water, Scooter Picnic, Meow Meme, and of course, Andy Merrill at MarsCon. And on the 9th in Howell, New Jersey, Carla Ulbrich. All right. Birthdays coming up on the 2nd. Phil Johnson, and coming up on the 3rd, Seamonkey. So happy birthday, guys.
But what birthday is coming up on today?
Who's today?
It would be
Meow Meme today, right? Yes.
Alexander Racy, a.k.a. Meow Meme, is 12 years old, an actual for reals leap year birthday day for Alexander at 12. Woo! Yay!
All right. All right. Joe is moving, apparently, so he like doesn't have a place to do anything from right now. So here is his song at Starbucks, Starchucks, by Joe J. Thomas.
They sell you coffee in a cup at Starbucks. Or half-cap latte with some soy in there. But when it comes to pay the bill, you're only there to fill the till. That money just evaporates in air. Them drinks are gonna make you fat at Starbucks. With calories and lots of sugar too. It's caffeinating through your mind and subjugating all mankind. But nowhere else is left for you to choose. Oh, no, 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 no. Oh. I finally understood the game at Starbucks and started up a knockoff brand that's deluxe. So now I own this coffee bar. It's like a money cookie jar. And I won't stop till I'm the czar of Starchucks. I won't stop till I'm the czar of Starchucks. No, 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 no.
won't stop till I'm czar of Starchucks. That's right, I said Starchucks.
Come on down, buy some coffee.
See, Trevor, 3 minutes and 2 seconds. That's how you do it, you see.
Right, right.
All right. Let's do some feedback.
Making the internet absolutely ridiculous. Dementia Radio.
www.dementiaradio.org. Port 8027.
Please hang up and try again.
This is the part where there's feedback.
Feedback.
Feedback. You know that segment of the show we do about now?
Feedback. Feedback.
Feedback.
Madman on the Loose wrote, when my daughter came home from work on Friday and noticed I was watching the cast on YouTube, she asked if I knew why Devo Spice was not going to MarsCon. Since Devo mentioned his situation 30 seconds before, I was able to let her know. Earlier that Friday, I wondered how much money from Spotify could be made by having a device put a Worm Quartet short song on repeat, since 10 plays in a minute would account for over $5 million in a year. So Ian mentioned Spotify doesn't pay for tracks under 30 seconds answers that. Thank you, Ken. Also, Spotify has ways of detecting that, and they will remove the song if they catch people doing that.
Mm-hmm.
And
it's almost like Spotify has a thing against people, you know, unfairly taking advantage of a system.
Yeah, you know, who
didn't
knew?
Bullpeck do that?
Who?
Bullpeck, didn't they put out an album that was like just a bunch of 30-second songs of silence, and then they asked their fans to stream it, and then Spotify was like, ah, crap, they're doing to us what we do to everybody else. We gotta shut this down.
That's pretty smart. All right. A-Log!
Oh my god, it's you, not again!
A-Log wrote, I still wish I would be able to go to MarsCon, but financial and job issues screwed me over on that regard. I would still love to meet Andy Merrill any way I could. And also, regarding Jellystone, I'm happy to hear George Lowe voice Space Ghost again, but I can tell that he has aged a bit since then. I also looked on Twitter, and someone said that Jim Conroy voiced Zorak. No one knows who voiced Moltron as of yet. I think it's appropriate, since Jim Conroy got his start doing impressions on MTV's Celebrity Deathmatch back in the late 90s. Thank you, A-Log. And
yeah, Moltar was pretty dead on. Like, Zorak was a little off, but I think he was trying to do more like original Zorak from the actual Space Ghost TV series than, you know, Zorak from, you know...
Yeah, the talk show.
that we know from Coast to Coast.
Yeah.
Have you ever heard what the original Brack sounded like?
I'm sure I have, but I don't remember.
It's thoroughly, it's nothing. It's just basically like, we must get Jen and Jace away from Space Ghost. You know, it's your typical 60s generic villain voice.
Which is what makes what Andy Merrill does so much funnier.
Yeah.
All right. Teasing.
Teasing. He's a teasing kind of guy. Now you have a job.
Yeah.
Tomorrow's song is by TV's Kyle.
Yeah.
And Tuesday's song is by Lauren Mayer. And tomorrow's Spotify playlist topic. Any suggestions? I could do... Did I do the Artist of MarsCon already? Did I do that?
I don't know if you did. It would be an appropriate time for you to do that.
It would. Let me see if I have done that. Where is my spreadsheet?
I mean, you've done it in past years. I don't think you've done it this year.
Yeah. Short songs, cars, bacon, classic video games... Songs Not to Have Sex To. That was a good one. Snow, Aliens. Okay, yeah, no, I haven't done it this year. Let's do MarsCon. MarsCon artists. All right. So, Joe J. Thomas is at joesdump.com. Trevor, plug yourself one more time.
Yes, hello. You can reach me at thumbnutsband@gmail.com. If you want me to produce or help write or instrumentalize one of your tracks, I'm happy to do it. Hit me up with whatever. We'll go nuts.
Sounds good.
Not like we did on our song. I promise you, it won't be what I made. It'll be good.
Sounds good. All right, let's get out of here. Thank you for listening to the Funny Music Podcast. I'm Devo Spice.
I'm Luke Ski.
And there's Trevor.
Thank you for listening to the Funny Music Podcast. You can listen live every Thursday night at 10 p.m. Eastern, 7 Pacific, at DementiaRadio.org and join us in the chat or subscribe to the podcast feed. Look us up on iTunes and be sure to leave us a review. Feedback for the show can be sent to info@thefump.com. The Funny Music Podcast is a production of FIDEM Interactive, LLC, released under a Creative Commons share-alike license. Tell your friends. Tell your enemies. Shout it to random people on the street. And be sure to visit thefump.com for the latest funny songs. Tune in next week where you'll hear Luke Ski say...
This is where Devo edits in that whole clip of him having edited me saying MarsCon over and over again. I'm pretty sure it was 2012.
I'll see if I can find it.